closer look at bills related to pharmacies. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative Pam DeLissio. Thanks for being with us.
Glad to be here.
These are bills actually that are related to parity when it comes to insurance coverage and prescription coverage. Give us an idea as to the background of this. Many people who go in for prescription coverage related to prescription drugs can go into a pharmacy, but many people actually have to mail away for their prescriptions.
Correct. And I know when the topic of health insurance comes up, folks, their eyes glaze over because it's a very complicated issue. So we'll try to make this very simple. Health insurance companies hire pharmacy benefit managers to help manage the prescription coverage that an insured use, you or I would use. Pharmacy benefit managers are responsible for the contracts that are negotiated with pharmacies as well as with mail order pharmacies. And it has come to my attention through the independent pharmacists that there are two different types of contracts that are negotiated. A very favorable one for mail order pharmacies and a much less favorable one for independent pharmacists. For example, a mail order pharmacy could fill a prescription for up to 90 days. An independent pharmacist is limited to only filling that same prescription for 30 days, causing the insured to have to pay a copay once every 30 days to get a 90-day supply. And a mail order pharmacy gets to fill it for 90 days and the insured only has to pay one copay for that 90 days. That's not the pharmacist who have made up these rules, it's the pharmacy benefit managers who made up these rules.
Now, there are actually two bills, one coming out of the House, one coming out of the Senate, that would actually change the way that this works in Pennsylvania. Talk to us a little bit about these bills that would create parity, not necessarily change your insurance, but change the way you could get access to your medication.
Correct. An employer would still have the option of saying, I only want my employees to have access to mail order versus independent pharmacy, but both contracts would be the same. The independent pharmacist could fill prescriptions the same way a mail order pharmacy could. That's all the bill is about, is parity. And interestingly enough, opponents of the bill would like one to think that this is going to create a situation whereby prescription prices are going to rise precipitously. And quite frankly, a lot of people, particularly older people, need face-to-face conversations with their pharmacists because taking medication today is very complicated and very confusing.
Now, is that a concern, though, with the costs associated with this? Because oftentimes when you do get things through the mail or you do get a larger supply of medication, that could potentially reduce the costs associated with prescription drugs.
Well, and if the independent pharmacists have that same opportunity to fill a prescription for 90 days, the customer will still have that reduced cost as well, but they will have the benefit of the professional expertise of the pharmacist face-to-face versus over the phone.
Now, there are two pieces of legislation, as we mentioned, one from the House, one from the Senate. Where do they stand?
I believe they are waiting to be brought to the floor for a vote by the House. That schedule is undetermined as of this time.
What kind of support have they generated?
Well, needless to say, independent pharmacists and a lot of consumers want the option. Some in businesses seem to feel that this somehow jeopardizes their ability to choose insurance, and it does not. I'm trying to make sure those businesses are better informed.
And we just have a short time left, but as you mentioned, you don't necessarily think that this would actually raise costs associated with prescriptions?
It would not. It just simply offers independent pharmacists the same opportunity that the mail order pharmacies have to serve customers.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Pam DeLissio. I'm Jill Horner.